गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। सो टुडे आई एक्चुअली वांटेड टू शो यू माय हाउस प्लांट्स, व्हिच इज आई एक्चुअली लिव इन अ रेंटेड अपार्टमेंट। सो आई शो यू द प्लांट्स व्हिच आई कीप ऑन माय बालकनी एरिया, एंड इट इज एन ईस्ट फेसिंग बालकनी। सो या, लेट्स बिगिन विद द हाउस प्लांट टूर।
सो द फर्स्ट प्लांट यू सी इज टर्टल वाइन, एंड इट लुक्स रियली ग्रेट इन hanging baskets, and I really like it because of the purple stem and the underside of the leaf is also purple. And this plant is a green variety, a Sansevieria dwarf variety, and it really looks great as Dex office Dex plant. And this one is an aloe vera plant. You can see it's throwing out new pops, and I don't know what disease it has, but do let me know in the comment section below. So here you can see this is a periwinkle plant. There are many varieties of these. I've seen the pink and the peach colored one, and this one which I have here is white. I don't know how it grew in this pot, but suddenly out of nowhere I saw this plant growing, and it's actually a kind of a weed growing around in India. So you see this plant everywhere, and it has all sorts of medicinal properties, and I've read some article that cancer medicines are made using periwinkle plant. And this one is a croton. It's a really beautiful one. I really like the lime green color of it, and especially the beautiful leaves. And you can see how nice it looks, as if someone has splattered pink color onto it. And I really like the color of it, and it is throwing out new flowers. Like it's you can see there, flowering stem is growing. And yeah, there you can see it is all big, and when the plant matures it throws out like flowers. So here I've planted a philodendron, a heartleaf philodendron, directly into soil so that it can propagate. If you want to see it, my philodendron actually caught a thrip, and you can actually go and watch my Instagram IGTV where I posted a video about thrip infestation. Thrip is a kind of insect. So here, the next plant here I have is a wandering Jew, and it is actually a really nice plant, and you can see the beautiful underside, a purplish color of the stem and the leaves. And I don't know what has happened, I don't know what, but I think it may be overwatering or underwatering. The leaves have all curled up. And yeah, the next plant here is a holy basil plant. I really like putting this onto my tomato soup. It really tastes amazing if you add a few leaves of basil, holy basil, into your tomato soup. So yeah, next to that is my philodendron Brazil. It's a small plant, I would say. I bought it as a cutting, and you must have seen this pot on my Instagram. If you don't follow me there, you can follow me. I'll put the links down below, and you can see it was a really small cutting, and it grew into such a big plant. I'm planning to cut it off, so hence the video. I was planning to cut this plant off, and that's the reason why I'm filming a house tour, so that I can like get the plants in full shot. So yeah. And yeah, I think my next video would be that. And you can see this leaf is so amazing, and I really like the way every leaf is different, and this new leaf is really amazing. I really like the way it looks, and every, like, let me just show you clearly. And it's really amazing to see, especially in creeping plants like these, every leaf is different, be it pothos and philodendron. I think these two plants have a really close corner in my heart. I really like these two varieties of plant. So yeah, and I think I would like to mention that always keep your house plants by searching onto the net. If you have small babies into your house, or dogs or cats, do note that there might be poisonous plants among these. So yeah, so the next plant here is a heartleaf philodendron, which I actually saved off from thrips. It had thrip infestation, and here you can see there are new shoots growing, and I really am happy that this plant actually got saved. And I had zero hopes with this plant, so yeah, I'm really happy that I was able to save this plant, because thrips are really not good insects. Like, they are really pesky pest, and yeah. So this one is a Syngonium variety. I don't know what has happened. There was a Syngonium white butterfly into this and it died. I don't know if it is still alive. So this one, this stem is a Diffenbachia stem. I don't know if it has roots or not. Let me just show you. So yeah, I think there's a root growing. I saw it somewhere. Yeah. So I kept it in water for its water propagation, and there you can see the white dot. That is the part where I think possibly the root will be growing. So the next plant you see here is another water propagation. I usually keep my plants in water because I travel a lot. So here you can see a Syngonium butterfly. It's a cutting. I did cut it into two plants. Like, I got the original mother plant and I cut it into two and I placed it there. You can see the new leaf one for. So this planter you might have seen on my Instagram channel, and yeah, here I've planted turtle vine again, and you can see turtle vine here quite clearly, and here along with golden pothos. And I got both of the cuttings from my sister-in-law, and I really like the turtle vine, and you can see the purple stem, and the underside of the leaf is quite different purple from the one you might have seen in the wandering Jew plant. And I really like the purple shade because it's different from wandering Jew purple. And I really like the pattern on the golden pothos plant. And yeah, and you can see there's new leaf growth. And this next plant is amaryllis. It's a summer flowering plant. It grows from bulb. And this one is a golden pothos. It was actually a golden pothos and turned to be it converted into neon pothos because I kept it inside while I was traveling, and it's in water. And yeah, I don't know how. I think maybe because there was no sunlight falling onto it, and here's the new growth. So yeah, it's a very tiny leaf. And then again, the next plant here you can see is a curry leaf plant, and it's usually used in Indian dishes, and most of the dishes you will see having this curry leaves. And it actually has a really nice smell to it, and very strong smell. So yeah, this next plant is Epiphyllum cactus. I'll put the names of all the plants in the description. And this one is actually, it blooms, gives out white flowers, and it can be propagated through leaf cuttings, and from the scalloping of the leaves, like from each scaffolding, you'll see a new plant growing. And it's very easy to propagate, and I got it in this ice cream container. I usually like reusing these sort of big ice cream jars like this, because you can actually reuse plastics. And I really like the thick leaves of it because it's really easy to maintain, and it's a really easy plant and it doesn't require much. So yeah, this is Epiphyllum cactus, and in Hindi it's called Brahm Kamal. It grows white, big white flowers, and that blooms during the night. So let me just take you to another plant here. I have Sansevieria. Green variety, again a dwarf variety of Sansevieria, and it here is one pup. You see two pups growing, and this one actually came along with pups when I bought it from nursery. It had one pup, now it has two, three pups. And this one is aloe vera. One I got it from my mother-in-law's house, and the other one was from here only. And this one is Haworthia. It's a very hardy succulent. If you are staying in a desert like climate of where you get a lot of direct sun, I would advise you to keep this plant outside, because Haworthia, I don't know about all the other species, but this one, this variant actually does really great, and the leaves are quite thick and it can tolerate a lot of sun, direct sun onto it. And yeah, it gets a lot of direct sun. And then there's aloe plant, the small pup. You can see it has discolored, it has turned into a different color because it was getting a lot of light, and I've not watered it. And then the next plant here in the white ceramic pot you can see here is a gasteria, and it was actually very little and it has thrown out new leaf, and it had pups too growing from below, like from the lower part of the stem, but I think they shriveled up and died. And previously there were pups, so I did plant, like potted it separately into these small pots. You can see here pups of Gasteria lilliputana, and then this one is again Sansevieria trifacta dwarf variant, and this one is very common. I think you'll get it in every nursery, and it has new leaf shooting out, and it was actually in really bad shape previously, but I actually was able to restore it back to place, and I'm really proud of that. So now I actually water it very less. And then here you see rattlesnake calathea, and it's not doing well. I hope it revives. And then here is the common Sansevieria trifecta. You'll see everywhere, and you can see that there's new growth growing. And Sansevieria actually like to be root bound, that's why I placed it into a small plastic reused bottle cutout. And yeah, I think that's it for the video. Thanks for watching, and I hope this houseplant tour was like enjoyable to you in some ways. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.